Okay. As promised, here is the build of this PMG permanent magnet generator motor kickstart to reduce wind generator cutting speed from 25 kilometers an hour to 13 kilometers an hour. In this case, anyway, the idea is it reduces the cutting speed. And that depends on your blades and everything else. Okay, so anyway, here are all the components. First we have a 2SC2625, which is similar to BU4522. The 10 amps current, 10 gain of 10, 10 amplification. And that's why we use the Darlington. This one is about 100. So, yeah. Well, I'll be showing the components as I solder them. Okay, so let's put this up there. Let's start with this guy. Let me just make sure it's in the screen. Yeah. Okay. It's fine. So I'll start from this guy because he's big. So he'll just build right on it. Okay. So then we have the 3N2922 transistor. We got base collector emitter. So collectors are together, collector. Base goes emitter. There's the base. Okay, so the base. Emitter goes to base. Okay. Collector goes to collector. Okay. And base. Is where the trim part goes. So it goes to ground. We don't have anything for ground yet. Okay, so let's start building over here. The 680 ohm resistor. It goes to emitter. this way so you can have access to adjustment. Okay, so we get that. And the 3.9K register base. Actually, it's on the same point as this one on the other side. Microfarad, 16 volts. This one is 63, 16, isn't it? This one goes to ground. Using too many wires. Y914, regular signal, signal diode.
Holder, alligator clip.
two. This is again 2 and 39/4. So we got the emitter. Collector goes to plus base. Goes to the other trim plots, 20 trim plots. Okay. Now we have 1 micro 50 volts. Capacitor. And also goes to the base. The inside. So let's build this LED resistor. Okay, so let's finish this. All right, so we got everything started up, connected. There's no shorts. Okay, so yeah, you can see. I don't have a very good camera set up here where I can't see the screen. Come on, focus. Wow. Still my focus. That's silly. Wonder why it doesn't focus. Yeah, I don't know why it doesn't focus. It should focus on that. Looks like a science fiction thing, but we have our two shrimp pots, three LEDs. That's the incoming, that's intermediate, or the other, this is incoming, intermediate, and output. So
now I'm just gonna hook up wire that connects to the system, which is these four wires.
So we got red plus, which is right here, collector, 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 right, okay. So red, this one here. Yellow, and so enter. Transistor. Yeah, this is not gonna be a nice close up zoom, as you can see some others, but I'm doing the best I can. Okay, and then minus, and minus capacitor, and all this stuff right here. Thank you.
come into the pouch register. Okay, now I'm just going to take this section of wire and cut this to length, and we're going there next and take the other one off and put this one on. All right. Here's the original. Gonna take off and mount a new one. Okay, well, I have mounted the kickstart right there to the board. Okay, and the wires are here and they're going to get connected. So right there. And just wants to focus the background. Disconnecting this one. Now the mill is just turning slowly to the stepper. Then we got the reed switch. Output get last level. And the ground. And here's the new one. So I've got the ground. Okay. Got the generator and the boost. I'll cover that later. Of course, this came off the boost plus. Okay. And I have the sensor. And finally we got the bus. And there it is. Oh, you got red. I didn't know that. There was red LEDs. That was green. Okay, so here we have it. It's working already. Oh shit! Stupid radio. Sorry about that. I hate when, you know, walkie-talkie in a pocket and just any touch presses buttons and house phone in the other, and that does number. I can't really focus. They're close. But you can see the red blinking one here, that's the sensor. The yellow one is the output, so output is on. And the you can't see through this hole like I can. And let's go from this other side. You can barely see the other intermediate signal, which is flashing there next to the red. Gotta separate those a little bit. But she's working. There you go. I'll take you outside now and show you the generator. It's just no wind right now. It's just kind of turbulent. So now it's kind of, now it's from south, so that should be about right. Now it's turning southwest. South. It's quite turbulent. And it's not spinning up yet. It's not quite up. But I have the adjustments there. I can adjust that to, for a little wider pulse. So it would have kicked in already. But it's so turbulent. See how it's turning around to different directions there. It's picking up. That's enough. I can adjust the. There she goes. Let's look at the meter here. Okay, so right now clipped, connected. There. 11:21. Spinning, and 22. It's not just barely spinning. Okay, so let's put it on amps. Reset. Now this thing just doesn't want to focus to foreground, just background always. So there's. Come on. One 45 watts.
That's together from solar and wind. If I go over here, that's just from the wind, 0.13 right now. So it's barely doing, but it's producing enough power. You can see that again there. Focuses like crazy on the background, but foreground, forget it. Okay. 169. Shows minus because I clipped it the other way. Okay, back to volts. And 27, 28. She's working. So there we get the circuit again, and it's a success. Come on, focus you. Wow. Really? Oh, I wasn't zoomed out. I zoomed in, that's why I didn't want to focus. Sorry for that. I was wondering, I said, what's going on here? So you can see the signal coming in, the ionometer is turning. It's kind of really slow right now. The yellow one is the output, and the other red, which you can barely see from blinking next to the yellow, is the intermediate. You can see a little bit here, but see how short the pulse is. Yeah, so by the way, I don't have a switch over here, but I'll bring one in, it's kind of going on. Pulse is a little longer now. So it should give it more kick. I think I'll reduce it a bit too. So when the generator is producing, yeah, I gotta go. This. Running at about 16 kilometers an hour wind speed. You can see the trees, top swaying, that one there and this one. Wind is pretty steady now, so she's keeping up. Okay, so long for now. Next we'll do the boost.